Doesn't do it. If your local church doesn't do If men's ministry doesn't do it, if women's ministry, youth ministry doesn't do it, and the other departments, if they don't do it, I thank God for the inspiration that's been given to the women of the church to do this. And it's good. And it's exciting. And it's professional. And it's top class. And your national overseer is very pleased for all of these. The National Women's Ministry, before I take my text, tell you a few things. It's the richest department of the church in the Turks and Caicos Islands. And they've raised enough money to do many things. The men's ministry need much prayers. And the youth ministry needs prayer without ceasing. In terms of getting your finances together. And so I thank God for all of you, and I'm sure there are more gifts to be given to these persons. I'll talk about that later. But I've been paying some attention. The text is Romans 16, you can turn to it. I've been paying a lot of attention to the North and Little Caicos. In fact, three or four Sundays I've been in this area. Pray for me tomorrow. I leave for Antigua. Overnight in Miami. As you know, I lead overseer for the Leeward Islands. We've got something like 50 or 60 churches there. And the regional convention starts Wednesday. Pray for me for this expanded role and work the church was given to me. But I was in Kamba, Bottle Peak, and today I was in Whitby, and always in Kew. But I paid attention to the congregation this morning in Whitby, and a tremendous amount of young people.
Amen.
A tremendous amount of young people. And this, I thought I saw the director of Christian Education. Yes, Renee is not here. But there you are, yes. To pay some attention to that congregation for me. And helping as best you can. Structuring. Yeah, God bless this tremendous work that you are doing. But I recognize the last time I was in Little Caicos, the microphones now look so clear, I can hear myself so well. And then in Bottle Creek, very well, and in Whitby, clearer, and in Kew, very much clearer. No cause for me to trip me. So I recognize the hand of the Director of Technology and Engineering, Anthony Williams. He's a young man. Since he is not here today, I'll tell you he's a young man who spends thousands of his own money perfecting the instruments, microphones, and setting up and helping both the convention and throughout the churches. So whenever you see him, bless him for me in the name of the Lord. And it is so well, very premature to have men and women in the church making these sacrifices all to the glory and honor of God. And as our buildings are becoming all in air condition, in Libby it was piping, in Hugh it was piping, and some of you will have much piping to do with the large churches of the creek, and others, but by the grace of God, Pastor Ronald and everyone else will get much things done. Look at someone and say, if we all pull together, we'll get the work done. Shake your hands and tell them that. If we all pull together, we will get the work done. And God bless you. Put your hands over your heart and say that the words in my mouth come out of your mouth. God bless you. Women of the Church of God of Prophecy, you are no small under the rock people. You are women of grace and distinction. You are virtuous. You have labored and are laboring, both in the Hispanic and Haitian congregations. You do labor as a virtuous woman.
Yes.
Not just yesterday, not just a few years ago, but it's a hallmark of your integrity. You've labored throughout the Turks and Caicos Islands. In point of fact, you've labored in the Bahamas. For all three churches in the Abacos, the seven in Grand Bahama, and four on the island of Providenciales, one in Great Managua, were all started with Turks and Caicos Islanders who emigrated to the Bahamas many years ago. But as God will have it, just as thousands of Turks and Caicos emigrated to the Bahamas, thousands of Bahamians are emigrating to the Turks and Caicos. The work of the Lord will continue, and God will raise up men and women of any nationality to get this work done. You believe it? In the Turks and Caicos Islands. In fact, you've got more pastors in the Turks and Caicos Islands who are not Turks and Caicos Islanders than those who are. This may be an interesting program for Pastor Mrs. Television Show. It may be interesting to see that the Word of God, Romans chapter 16. 16, verse 1. I command unto you Phoebe, our sister, which is a servant of the church, and said, Jim, women, I know of the work of all of these women that you are honoring. If they see water spilled on the floor, come on, help me out. They go and get them up and clean it up. How many of you women do that? Oh my Lord, how many women do it? How many of you women pick up papers on the church? Only one or two. How's it good? And getting to this, the servant, a woman as a servant of the church, does not say cleaning the church and cleaning the bathroom belongs to the janitors. Amen.
Amen.
Wherever you see nastiness, come on, say
clean it up.
Amen. Wherever you see paper, come on, pick it up and throw it away. In the garden. You've got to be a servant of God. For the saying says, cleanliness is what? You have to be a clean woman. A clean servant woman. One thing women of God in the Turks and Papers has got a good existence and good credit for, you can dress. Oh boy, you can dress. Amen. And you're getting dressed like the Bahamian sisters who at the mention time brags that she's got dress and jewelry on. That's your business. But become a servant of God.
Amen.
Sisters, become a clean servant of God. I'm the last one. A clean one. Amen. Become one that will take care of the tabernacle.
Amen.
Look into it. Was a servant of the church. And Phoebe, if it was time to play the keyboard, Phoebe would play the keyboard. When it's time to play whatever Phoebe can play, she must play. I like Sister Dorcas of this church. She would beat the cymbal. She doesn't play the guitar, does she? In other words, whatever your hand finds to do, in the church, come on, sisters, do it.